Welcome back, Pokemon fans. My name is Jonathan Indovino, and I'm joined by Dwi Ha, and we are going to be jumping in to our Juniors National Championship match. Dwi, how do you feel right now?
I feel so excited. I mean, we've been playing all weekend long, and now we are down to just three more matches to determine the champions here in the Junior Division, the Senior Division, and the Masters Division. So, you know, it's been a long weekend for all players out here, and they've all got to be really proud about how they've performed this weekend.
Absolutely. Making it this far, and making it, just being here is just, it's been a blast. It's been so much fun, but it's kind of coming down to the nitty-gritty. We are going to find out who our champions are going to be. And that's always fun, you know, playing through the Pokemon games. You reach that point where you become the champion in-game, and these trainers have an opportunity to be a real-life Pokemon champion. I just think that's awesome.
I know. There's so much going on the line right now. I mean, if you think about it, how many people have wanted to be champions of Pokemon for the longest time, ever since they were kids, right?
I've wanted to be a champion for the longest time, and I still, you know, still haven't got there, but, you know, chugging away.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, these juniors, these seniors, and the masters, you know, they've worked hard all season long, right? They've been working all year long to really culminate down to this, to come down to the national champions and win this championship and move on to the world championships, right?
Absolutely. I mean, it doesn't end here. It doesn't end here for most of the trainers today and throughout this weekend that have competed. Of course, there's going to be the world championship going on, and that's going to be just another title that these trainers are going to want to grab. But I think we're ready. We're going to throw it over to the player card so we can get a little familiar with what these two trainers have done. We have London Swan's trainer card on the screen. He is in the junior division, of course, and he has been the 2015 regional. He got first place at the 2015 regionals. You can see his team on the screen as well, which I see Scrafty, and Scrafty gets me a little excited. I love that Pokemon. It's such an awesome Pokemon to see.
I think London's also kind of omitting the fact that he is a runner-up at the World Championships last year, so a little bit of a modesty right there, I think.
A little modesty. You know, I didn't win it, so we're not going to put it on my player card, you know, but I was runner-up, so that's definitely a huge feat there. And we're going to jump it over to Aiden's card now to see what his season has been like or what his circuit has been. He was second at a 2015 regional, so both of these players familiar with regionals. We can also see his team on the screen. You see that Milotic. You see the Ludicolo with his hands up, ready to go and possibly help Aiden win this national championship. So, Dwi, what do you think? We just saw a quick glimpse of both those teams. What do you think this match is going to end up looking like?
I think it's going to be a really close matchup between the two. I mean, we see Aiden running that Sand team with that Tyranitar, Excadrill, Aegislash, Salamence core that's really popular right now in the older division. So, you know, that goes to show exactly how ready Aiden is to come in and take this championship. On the other side, we do see London going with the Gardevoir, Scrafty, Amoongus, Heatran, Thundurus, and Landorus. You know, that's also a very standard team. Mega Gardevoir is most likely the Mega right there. You know, it's gaining popularity really fast. We see it, you know, dominating the Masters division right now. I mean, two of the finalists in the Masters division have the Gardevoirs too. So it's going to be an exciting battle between these two players. Both these players have really solid teams, and I'm really excited to see what they can do, you know?
Absolutely. I know. You can look at these teams, and it's the junior division, and it's nothing to scoff at. These players have made it so far and have put a lot of time into building their teams and to making it here today. It's very exciting. I'm pumped. I'm anxious. I really just want to see who's going to be our junior national champion. We're going to go ahead and throw it over to the stage so Justin can talk to these players and we can find out exactly how they're feeling.
Thank you so much, Jonathan, and hello, Pokemon fans. Let's hear it for your possible junior national champions on stage here, guys. They have battled so hard this weekend. 2 days of grueling competition in the juniors bracket. Of course, London Swan and Aiden here. You saw some of their achievements, but London also, I think it might not have been on there, was the runner-up in 2014 World Championships. Are you excited to be here at the National Championships on your way back to Worlds?
Yes, I'm excited and a little nervous.
I would be too, man. You've come so far. Congratulations. And are you feeling excited as well to be up here on the national stage?
Yeah, but I have a shout out.
Go for it. I feel you. Drop those names.
Kyle Smith, who's probably watching the stream right now. He taught me how to breed Pokemon. And I could call him my mentor.
Wow, that is awesome. Talk about that camaraderie in the scene here. I think all of us have learned how to play Pokemon from someone else at one time or another. So big shout out to Aiden's homie there. And anyone you want to give a shout out to or a thanks to anyone watching?
Maybe my brother, my older brother in Masters, who helped me with my team.
Oh, man, that is too awesome. Families and friends training together, playing Pokemon, guys. Good luck to the both of you. We're going to throw it back to the caster desk. Let's hear it one more time for these juniors. Both amazing players and could be your future national champion right here.
Well, thank you so much for that, Justin. You know, it really is heartwarming, honestly. I'm a little bit of a sap myself, so it's really, really cool when trainers want to shout out people that have gotten them into the game or helped them get where they are. It's such an awesome thing to see that Pokemon transcends age and you can build bonds with anyone.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm pretty sure that the people watching at home, you know, London's older brother or Aiden's friend right now, watching either from home or they might be here. I mean, they're probably really proud to see that their loved ones are up on stage right now, you know, playing for the national championship. So, you know, That must be really heartwarming. For
Absolutely, there's a lot on the line. As we stated before, you have the pride of being the champion. You have scholarship awards out the wazoo. There's so much that the Pokemon circuit gives to us. Besides the camaraderie, you get just that pride of being the champion, the national champion. It's going to be so awesome. I know our players are getting ready on stage. We had seen the teams already, so we can kind of go into that a little bit. You had mentioned the sand team on Aiden's side is definitely looking very powerful. You can see he has the Tyranitar, which is going to set up his sand. He's got Excadrill to take advantage of that. And of course, Excadrill kind of puts on a little pressure for that Gardevoir we were mentioning before on London's side.
Yeah, Excadrill is going to be hitting Gardevoir very super effectively, and the fact that Tyranitar gets that sand up, that's going to allow Excadrill to paddle through the sand really fast with that sand rush ability and, you know, hit Pokemon really fast and really, really, you know, for a lot of damage. I mean, Excadrill is one of those Pokemon that doesn't have to train too much in speed since it started getting that speed boost and instead, you know, focus on attack, maybe a little bit of bulk if it really wants to.
Absolutely. I mean, Excadrill is just one of those Pokemon that's really good typing. I mean, it does have that ground weakness, of course, which can be taken advantage of throughout matches by the Landorus that's on London's team, and of course Scrafty, a Pokemon that's over there as well, which is kind of going to hinder that physical attack from the Excadrill and also provide super effective damage with fighting type attack moves.
Right, we see the Scrafty, we see the Landorus on London's side. You know, that has Intimidate, that's going to be slowing down the Excadrill and the Salamence, but you know, you have to be careful because Aiden does have the Milotic. You know, the Milotic is going to be able to like take advantage of those Intimidates, you know, those stat drops, and instead turn them into positive stat boosts for that Milotic in the special attack category. We did see Milotic yesterday in the Masters division. You know, we saw it get a lot of boosts, and this is one of the reasons why Milotic's actually become really popular. You know, competitive is such a good ability right now, especially considering the fact that Intimidate is everywhere. You know, we see two Pokemon on London's side that does have the Intimidate. It's going to come in handy, but at the same time, London's going to have to be careful about when he's going to Intimidate. You know, Milotic can come in and just eat up those Intimidate drops.
Absolutely. We've seen Milotic run rampant throughout this weekend, and both players are jumping into this match. Now we're going to see what they're going to do with their leads. You can hear the crowd through the mics cheering on both trainers as they fight to be the next junior national champion. Aiden is, of course, issuing a challenge. We're going to see Thunders and Gardevoir are going to lead on London's side. We're going to see that Gardevoir kind of show off its shine. And then we're going to see Salamence and Milotic come through. So leading with the Milotic, trying to catch an Intimidate competitive boost, but that is not going to happen this time around.
This is dangerous right here. Gardevoir could possibly trace that Intimidate and give Milotic a boost.
Uh-oh. Are we going to see the trace? It's going to trace the competitive instead. Unfortunately, a turn too late because it is slower than the Salamence.
Yeah, and that was an unfortunate turn of events right there. Right now, I think Aiden's a little bit excited that, you know, the Gardevoir didn't trace that Intimidate, so you know Aiden kind of coming out of that a little bit with the edge.
Absolutely, and we're going to see both players make their moves very fast. Salamence is going to get out of there as Gardevoir does Mega Evolve. Now Aiden's going to have to be very careful about if he decides to bring in. Actually, he doesn't have to because the Gardevoir did Mega Evolve and lose that trace competitive ability. So we're going to see exactly what both players want to do. Gardevoir is just going to go on the safety and go ahead and protect itself, making sure it doesn't take any damage. Thunder Wave is going to come out and it's going to paralyze the Aegislash. Although it is already a slow Pokemon, a secondary full paralysis is never something you want to deal with throughout a match. And Milotic's just going to go for recover, expecting a hit, but no hit was given in that time.
Yeah, and one of the things that London really tried to do there was that, you know, try to slow down that Salamence. Salamence is a really problematic Pokemon for London's team right now. It's going to be able to outspeed that Gardevoir and hit it really hard with possibly an Aerial Ace, Double Edge, or Return, whatever move it really chooses to use.
Absolutely. We're going to see the Milotic go for the Protect as Thunderous goes for the Taunt on that Aegislash, preventing it from using any moves such as King's Shield. It can only attack at this point. We're going to see Aegislash, though. It is going to change stances, go on the offensive. Who will it target down with this Flash Cannon? It looks like he's going to be targeting down the Gardevoir. It's going to do a lot of damage, but leave it at 40 HP, not able to pick up the knockout there.
Yeah, so good position right now from Aiden. You know, he's done so much in the damage trade right now, all at the cost of getting Aegislash paralyzed. Gardevoir right now on the edge of getting knocked out right here. Most likely going to go down unless London decides to do some switching or some protecting with that Gardevoir. You know, Aegislash will probably be able to survive any attack from that Gardevoir. You know, that Steel typing is coming in such handy for that Aegislash, and we just see Aegislash withdraw.
Absolutely, yeah, I was going to say Aegislash is just going to want to play as safe as possible. It's not in its shield form, so it's going to want to go back to its trainer, and Ludicolo is going to come out in its stead. Thundurus is going to go ahead and go for a Thunderbolt, connecting on the Ludicolo because it's... He gets the para on the Thunderbolt! That's two Pokemon on Aiden's side of the field that are now paralyzed and run the risk of secondaries. The Hyper Voice is going to take the Ludicolo out. It's a crit on the Ludicolo. It's going to come out and get punished by that critical hit. We're going to see the Moringa Berry is going to be eaten by the Milotic, trying to munch away after suffering a little bit of damage. And Thundurus is going to dodge an Icy Wind. A nimble dodge. No speed lowering on that side. Gardevoir is going to be able to survive that Icy Wind. Lowering its speed may come into handy, especially now that both Pokemon are paralyzed on Aiden's side of the field.
Yeah, and... You know, we see that Moringa Berry activate. That's an item we saw yesterday again on Wolfie Glixa. Milotic, we do see it have recovery too, so most likely this Milotic is going to want to try to stay on the field and support Aiden's team as much as possible. One of the things that's really important about this game is, you know, speed control.
Yes.
And Milotic with that Icy Wind is most likely going to be Aiden's form of speed control, since we do not see the sand being brought right now. We don't see Tyranitar and the Excadrill, so Milotic is going to want to try to stay on the field, recover, you know, get that special defense boost, and continue to Icy Wind.
Absolutely. Aegislash is going to go ahead and go for the Wide Guard, expecting the Hyper Voice, but we just saw that Gardevoir. It did, in fact, go for the Protect. Another taunt on that Aegislash, really preventing it from using that Wide Guard or the King's Shield. Milotic's going to recover up to regain some HP that it took from the previous attack, that Hyper Voice from Gardevoir.
Yeah, and we do see Thunderous go ahead and taunt that Aegislash. That's a very smart move right there, because once that Aegislash goes on the offensive, it cannot King's Shield to go back into that shield form, which Aegislash really wants to do to get its defenses back. Milotic right now, not in the best position. Though it does have that special defense boost, it's going to be, you know, tough to deal with this Gardevoir and this Thunderous, double targeting it with Hyper Voices and a Thunderbolt possibly.
Absolutely. It's really cool to see some similarities, like you mentioned, between a master like Wolf and Aiden here today. So we're going to see the Amoongus come out for the Gardevoir, not really wanting to let it go down yet. Another Thunderbolt is going to connect on the Aegislash. An Icy Wind is going to connect on both of London's Pokemon. That's going to be some speed control there, although Amoongus doesn't mind being slowed down. The plant that it is doesn't really like to run much. It's a crit on Amoongus, not mattering too much because that thing is so bulky, able to take so many hits, whether they're super effective or not. We're going to see Aegislash does go into offensive mode, but it is going to break through any sort of paralysis chance, getting a Flash Cannon off on that Amoongus, still doing a good amount of damage, but that was a nice switch by London, preserving his Gardevoir a bit longer.
Yeah, and Amoongus right now on the field, that's going to be really problematic because right now Aegislash has no way to protect itself from being put to sleep, and Milotic sleeping itself is not going to be any help at all. Amoongus is a very bulky Pokemon, and you know the only move that Milotic has to really hit that Amoongus right now is that Icy Wind, and that's not going to be picking up the knockout anytime soon. You know, you might need like two more Icy Winds at least in order to pick up that knockout on the Amoongus.
Absolutely, and we're going to see the Icy Wind come out right now. It's going to go ahead and connect on both of London's Pokemon. Amoongus is going to be able to survive that as well as Thunders. It is another crit. That is our third crit. Can we get a crit counter? That is our third crit this game. Thunders is going to go ahead and munch away on that Citrus Berry. We're going to see what this Amoongus does. It can't very well put the Aegislash to sleep, but the because it's already paralyzed, but I believe it will be fast. We're going to see a Thunderbolt connect. It is going to just barely miss the knockout on the Aegislash, but Aegislash gets fully paralyzed, not able to take advantage of hanging on by a thread.
Yeah, and right there, you do see the spore into that Aegislash slot. Either that Aegislash was going to get knocked out by that Thunderbolt, or you know, you'd expect an Aegislash to switch out since it can't go back into shield form. So safe play right there from London to target down that spore into that slot right there. If Aegislash got knocked out, you know, that spore would simply target down that Milotic. If Aiden decided to switch out that Aegislash to preserve it for later on, you know, he'd get the switch in, the swirl on the switch in.
Absolutely, that was a brilliant, brilliant move. We're going to see a Scald come out. It's going to connect on the Thunders, doing a good amount of damage. We're going to see a burn, a Scald burn. Thunderbolt is going to come through and finish off that Aegislash right there. It's going to go down with, I think it probably had like 3 HP left, so there's no way we're surviving that attack, especially in Sword form. We're going to see a Spore, though, putting the Milotic to sleep, so London is putting himself in a fantastic position in this game.
Yo, absolutely, and... you know, Thunderous right now can easily also taunt that Milotic, prevent it from recovering. Amoongus can Giga Drain that Milotic, do a lot of damage back to it. And Thunderous also has, you know, that same type of attack boost, the Thunderbolt, that's also very powerful off Thunderous's special attack stat.
Absolutely. We're going to see the Salamence come in, getting a bit of a useless Intimidate off, as both these Pokemon have pretty much revealed that they are not physical attackers.
Right, and right now, London up 4-2. Milotic is currently sleeping, and Salamence right now is in danger of being paralyzed. Although Salamence can easily pick up the knockout on the Amoongus, and Thunderous, you know, it kind of has a counter on it as to when it's going to knock out with that burn residually chipping away at it. So London right now probably wants to try to paralyze that Salamence in order to control the speed a little bit more.
Definitely. It is the last Pokemon that is really threatening London, so I wouldn't be surprised if we do see a Thunder Wave here connecting with it. Thunders is going to go for that Thunder Wave, obviously targeting down that Salamence because the Milotic is, like you said before, it's sleeping right now. It's just sleeping. A Hyper Voice is going to come through from that Salamence. It's going to be able to pick up the knockout on the Amoongus, but it's going to miss the knockout on Thunderous because it is not very effective, but I think the burn is going to go ahead and pick up that knockout. I believe Milotic still taking that nap, enjoying its time on the field, full HP, not really worried about anything. Thunderous is going to go down to that burn, so just as quickly as it was a favorable position for London, it is now tied up.
Yeah, even though it is 2-2 right now, you know, you have a sleeping Milotic, you have a paralyzed Salamence with the Gardevoir and one more Pokemon that we haven't seen in back yet, so it's still not the best position for Aiden to be in.
That's true. The Gardevoir, though, is at a very low end of HP, and Milotic does have the special defense increase, and with Heatran coming in, it's not really looking too promising for London.
Yeah, and right now that Milotic does not mind seeing that Heatran at all. Heatran, of course, usually carries Earth Power, Heat Wave, Flash Cannon, you know. You gotta be careful with the Flash Cannon.
The Salamence just goes down! I don't want to cut you off, but the Salamence just completely drops to that Hyper Voice. Oh my goodness. We're gonna see that Heatran go for the substitute. Gonna take advantage of this sleeping Milotic. Milotic is gonna wake up, though. Go for a Scald. Is he gonna target down the Gardevoir? He's gonna opt to target on the Heatran. Targets down the Gardevoir, taking it out, making the perfect play, as he knows that Heatran kinda just gonna have to stumble through its way to try to win this match.
Yeah, and Heatran was probably not the best Pokemon for London to have in the back right there, unfortunately. This Milotic currently with one stage of increased special defense. We already seen that has access to recover. It can recover off any damage that Heatran can do. And, you know, of course, I've already said, Heatran has access to either Earth Power, Flash Cannon, or Heat Wave. Since it has a substitute, you'd probably expect Flash Cannon or Earth Power, one of those. And, you know, Heat Wave as the other move, but, you know, Flash Cannon and Earth Power can possibly reduce Milotic's special defense and give itself a competitive boost.
Yeah, activating that competitive could be pretty dangerous as it could lead to a one-hit knockout after knocking out the sub. We're going to see a Scald connect on the Heatran. It's going to be able to hopefully take out this substitute depending on how these trainers trained their Pokemon. We're going to see the substitute fade right there, and once again, Milotic is just known for doing two things, you know. One, stealing my socks, knocking them off, and two, just surviving, and with this extra special defense, we'd have to see a critical hit from London's side to really put him back in a good position. We're gonna see the Earth Power come through right there on the Milotic, not able to do a lot of damage, and a Scald's gonna come out from Aiden's side. Will it pick up the knockout this turn? It will not pick up the knockout this turn.
Yeah, and right now, Aiden is actually in very good position to just finish off this game at the end of this turn. Milotic right now just sitting pretty. If it wants to, we can recover, but looks like a Scald should be able to pick up a knockout from this range.
Absolutely, we're going to see that Earth Power connect on the Milotic, but once again, not doing enough. And we're going to see the Milotic recover just for safety. Oh my goodness, that might be just a tad disrespectful.
Well, I mean, it's also a safe play because just in case that Scald didn't pick up a knockout on that Heatran this turn, that would have put Milotic in a really bad position. So, you know, a safe play right there from Aiden just to secure the victory. You
absolutely.
Know?
You don't want to let a victory this close, especially when you're fighting for the national champion title, slip away just by being over-anxious, over-zealous, going for a Scald. But we're going to see that Scald come out after surviving Heat Power, and that Scald does pick up the knockout. So game one is going to go to Aiden. He is one step closer, but London is not counted out yet. That was an excellently well-played game. Oh, my gosh. I can't even speak right now. This is incredible.
Yeah, absolutely. And we do see London not really trying to bring his Intimidators because of, you know, that Milotic presence, right? We saw Gardevoir, Amoongus, Thunderous, and that Heatran, so London really scared to bring that Intimidate in order to boost that Milotic, so a good call right there from Aiden to kind of keep what London's going to be bringing in check. You know, that Scrafty is not going to want to try to appear at the same time as that Milotic, and Lalanders also doesn't want to try to appear at the same time as that Milotic either. So, He was really close.
It was a very well-played game. You can hear the crowd getting pumped as we get into game two right now. Both players are choosing their Pokemon. Milotic, just a Pokemon being on the team, whether you've seen it or not, like you said, it made London think, I don't want to risk bringing these intimidating Pokemon because they're going to intimidate and Milotic's not going to care. He's just going to go ahead and get a competitive boost off that.
Right, and then you're going to be hitting Milotic with, you know, special attacks. That's going to activate the Moringa Berry, give Milotic another boost to that special defense, and instead you have a Milotic out on the field with two stages of increased special attack and one stage of increased special defense. You know, that thing's going to be sitting on the field for a very long time, especially since now we see access to recover. One thing that I'd like to see is that Thunderous from London side going a little bit more on the offensive against that Milotic. You know, it did spread a lot of status with that Thunder Wave. You know, it did a lot of good things. It taunted that Aegislash, paralyzed that Aegislash, you know, just for chances. It paralyzed that Salamence. But at the same time, it kind of just left that that Milotic on the field just do whatever it really wanted to, you know. Taunt can be helpful. It could prevent that Milotic from being able to recover all that damage that, you know, London builds up on it. And you don't want to see that. You don't want to see yourself build up a lot of damage on that Milotic and then just have it recover it off. That's just heartbreaking.
Definitely. We even saw in that first game, Aiden did go for the recover turn one just in case he did get hit by that Thunderbolt. We're going to see both Pokemon choose their leads. This time, Aiden's decided to go with the Sand, leading with Tyranitar and Excadrill. And we're going to see London go ahead and lead with the Amoongus and the Thunderous. Probably going to want to try to slow things down, although we know you cannot Thunder Wave an Excadrill, so there's no slowing that thing down.
Right, and Excadrill is actually a very good counter to that Thunderous, in my opinion. I mean, Thunders can't really touch it with much. You know, it's immune to Thunderbolt, it's immune to Thunder Wave. You know, you don't want to swagger if that Thunders is carrying swagger, right? You don't want to boost a physical attacker's attack by two stages.
Absolutely not. And we're going to see the Salamence come in on Aiden's side. Just wanted to set that Sand up really quick, bring T-Tar back close to home, preserve it for perhaps later, not wanting to be powerless. But we're going to see a Thunder Wave connect on the Salamence.
Oh, no.
And slowing that dragon down is going to be a bit of trouble for Aiden, but looking good for London right now. We're going to see a Rock Slide from that Excadrill come out. It is going to do a lot of damage to the Thunders. Actually, it does about 40% of very well-trained Thunders. So we're going to see a Spore connect from the Amoongus on the Excadrill. That fast mole is no longer a threat. It's sleeping.
It's no longer paddling through that sand right now with that Sand Rush ability. We do know that Excadrill isn't going to be moving at least for the next turn. That's one of the good things about Amoongus going for a Spore. You know, it's going to move after, and Excadrill is going to be guaranteed at least one turn of sleep. A really good rear right there, you know. A lot of these teams that do carry Excadrill and Tyranitar, you know, the Tyranitar is most likely Choice Scarf. Right, and that Thunder Wave targeting that Tyranitar slot was just a little bit of safe measure. You know, you don't want a fast Tyranitar out on the field and, you know, double rock sliding with that Excadrill and that Tyranitar. So good call right there from London to go for the Thunder Wave on that slot and, you know, really punishing that Salamence switch in.
Absolutely, and we're going to see Aiden try to fight through this paralysis. Mega evolving his Salamence as Amoongus goes for the Rage Powder, which is going to go ahead and draw in all attacks that aren't spread damage towards itself, kind of leaving Thunderous hopefully not in any danger. Excadrill is going to spend its first turn sleeping. Thunderous is going to go for the Hidden Power, targeting down the Salamence. It is not going to be able to pick up the knockout right there. And Salamence is going to go for the Hyper Voice, which is going to hit both of London's Pokemon, doing a load of damage to the Amoongus. Oh my goodness, just barely missing that knockout. But will the sand be enough to pick up the knockout? We're going to have to wait a couple seconds to find out if that's going to be the case. Even Salamence does not enjoy the sand that its partner brought. But we're going to see the Amoongus go down to the sand. That is one down for London. Aiden is taking a short lead right here, a quick lead.
Yeah, and you know, it's always great to see an Amoongus get knocked out because, you know, Amoongus is such a disruptive Pokemon with that Rage Power. We do see Hyper Voice bypass that Rage Power though, so one of the benefits of running the special Salamence is that Hyper Voice can also get a little bit chip damage on the Thunder Strike we saw.
Absolutely, and we're going to, I think right now Aiden's kind of just going to be hoping that his Excadrill can go ahead and pick up those sand paddles so he can start running rampant through this sandstorm, of course. Something you don't want to see, as you said before, with Salamence being a fast Pokemon, slowed down with the paralysis, and then Excadrill sleeping. He's kind of at London's mercy right now.
Right, and right now with Landorus-Therion coming out onto the field, you know, that's going to be able to threaten that Excadrill with a very powerful Earthquake. Good thing that Thunderous is out on the field right now, and Salamence, since it's paralyzed, Thunderous is going to be able to move before that Salamence and go for another Hidden Power to be able to pick up that knockout on Salamence. So even though London did lose that one Pokemon, right now London has a lot of momentum going into this turn.
London is in such a favorable position, especially because he's already seen the Tyranitar in the back, which is also weak to that Earthquake. So Landorus, there's really only one option for it to do right now, unless London is going to try to play around some sort of prediction. We're going to see the Excadrill actually withdraw right now. We're going to see the Milotic come in, a very smart play, I believe, probably fearing that Earthquake that would potentially. We're going to see Landorus actually go for the Super Power. So avoiding super effective damage right here, Milotic's going to be able to take that, take around 35, 40% HP, and Landorus is going to have its stats drop. Thunderous is going to go for that Hidden Power, and Salamence, I think, is going to be going down this turn. The dragon says goodbye.
And a really good switch right there. You know, Milotic could come in and take an Earthquake, but, you know, London instead going for the Super Power in that slot, probably expecting a Tyranitar switch or just wanted to get damage in, doesn't want to lock himself into the Earthquake just yet, you know, so good call right there from London, but an even better read from Aiden. We do see that Milotic back, but it's just unfortunate that, you know, it came in one turn too late. You know, it missed getting Intimidated to get that competitive boost as we see Tyranitar come back in.
Definitely. It is unfortunate that Milotic, had it gotten the competitive boost, the icy winds that it can start throwing London's way would be even more devastating.
Yeah, and Tyranitar coming in, that's going to be huge.
We're going to see a superpower target on the Tyranitar. It's minus one attack, but it looks like it's just barely going to miss the knockout because of the previous stat drop on the superpower. Oh my Lanza. A Thunderbolt is going to come through and connect on the Milotic. Is it going to pick up the knockout? It is going to pick up the knockout. London is kind of just commanding this battle right now, putting such a perfect position. Rock Slide, though, is going to come out from that Tyranitar. It does get the same type of attack bonus. Is it going to knock out the Thunderous? It is going to knock out the Thunderous and do a good amount of damage to that Landorus.
Yeah, so right now it's 2-2 with a sleeping Excadrill coming back in. Tyranitar heavily damaged, going to be threatened by that Landorus. We do see that the Thunderous moves before that Tyranitar. So information right there for London that that Tyranitar is not going to be carrying a Choice Scarf. As we see Gardevoir switch in, right now, it looks like London is actually in very good position right now.
Oh my goodness, this is such a, oh my gosh, tracing the Sandrush. Now, even if London decides to Mega Evolve, of course, speed and turn order is decided prior to Mega Evolution. So that Gardevoir is the fastest thing on the field right now.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, that's such a good thing to pick up, you know, especially since you're in the sand. You know, that's always a good thing. Right now, probably going to go Mega, probably just going to go for the Hyper Voice, going to be able to pick up the knockout on the Tyranitar, and, you know, just a superpower and that extra shield should be able to pick up the knockout right here.
Exactly. We just saw Gardevoir steal those Sand Paddles, that Sand Rush ability from Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! The wake-up is there. I spoke too soon. Picking up the knockout on Landorus. Will the Gardevoir flinch? The Gardevoir flinches!
Oh, no.
And the Assurance!
Oh, no.
I'm losing my mind right here. I am losing my mind. We're going to see the Gardevoir go down. And something we did not think would happen that fast, Aiden goes ahead and takes the 2-0 victory, becoming the national champion of the United. Oh my goodness, I'm losing my mind. Dwee, take it.
That was such a good series between the two. Oh man, Aiden kind of came out of nowhere for that one right
that
there.
That wake up, we just thought that mole did not like the paddles being stolen, did not like it, went ahead and just stripped. Oh my goodness, that was incredible.
That battle was absolutely intense, and you know, Aiden played exceptionally well. London also played exceptionally well, too. I mean, London put himself in a position to win, right?
He really
did. You
know,
London is a solid player. We saw him play exceptionally well right there. He brought all the pieces that he needed to pick up the victory, but it's just Aiden slightly edged out London right there. In that best of three series.
That Excadrill just woke up exactly when it needed to. I believe it had already slept, though, for multiple turns, at least one turn. So it was bound to happen. There was a good chance of that waking up, but it slipped my mind. That Excadrill just caught me off guard. It was beautiful. It was beautiful to watch.
And one of the things that happened a couple turns before that Excadrill woke up, you know, we saw that switch from Excadrill into that Milotic. Milotic wasn't really doing too much, you know, in that matchup anyways, right? You know, it could sit there, but it just got knocked out from Superpower and Thunderbolt from that Thunderous anyways. One of the important things about that Excadrill switch, it reset its attack stat.
Yes.
And that was enough to, you know, be faster than that Landorus in the sand and go for that Rock Slide, which picked up the knockout on the Landorus.
And it might not have picked up that knockout on the Landorus if its attack stat was still lowered, because the Rock Slide move is only neutral damage. It is not super effective towards the Landorus.
Right, absolutely. It's one of those situations where, you know, you got to think a couple turns ahead, just in case, right?
That was absolutely incredible to watch, and actually I am so excited to be interviewing the winner of that match after this short break. You can hear the crowd cheering on the new junior national champion. Both players did play exceptionally well, but when we get back, we will be talking to our national champion. Welcome back, Pokemon fans. I'm Jonathan Indovino, and I'm joined by our new junior national champion, Aiden. Aiden, how do you feel right now after such an incredible set?
Really good.
You feel really good. I think that I would feel really good if I was a new national champion, getting a trophy. I know you had said you had a friend that you had given a shout out to. How do you think he feels right now?
Really good.
I love it. I love it. Everyone's just feeling really good as we have that set behind us. Now, were you planning on that Excadrill waking up? Was that what you were counting on in that moment?
Yeah, I actually was. I was hoping that it would be a miracle if he woke up and flinched the Gardevoir. That was all that I was hoping for, though.
And it was, in fact, a Poke miracle right there. Absolutely beautiful moment. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Not really. But to be honest, I really thought that London was actually going to take that.
Yeah? You thought he was going to take game two?
I thought he was going to take the whole thing.
Oh, really? What made you that? What gave you that impression?
Well, he got second in Worlds, and that's a really big accomplishment.
Of course, that is a huge accomplishment. So that was that in the back of your mind while you were playing him?
Yeah.
Absolutely. I can see that being a little intimidating, much like that's probably why you brought that Milotic, just in case it was a little intimidating, you know? You get it? No? Okay.
Yeah.
So we're going to go ahead and brush over that really quick. I'm just curious, how long did you spend making that team? How long have you been playing with it?
I had probably done over 300 battles on it, with on rating battles.
Over 300 battles on Battle Spot?
Yeah, on Battle
Over Spot. 300 battles on Battle Spot. So some of you guys, if you've been practicing on Battle Spot, you may have run into Aiden. Maybe you got the same treatment with Excadrill waking up and flinching you with that rock slide. Well, Aiden, once again, congratulations. I'm really glad that Poke Miracle happened for you.
I can't
express how happy I am for you to be here and talking to you. It's just, you're a national champion, dude. It's just awesome. We're going to go ahead and get out of here. We're going to, when we get back, we will have another exciting match. Another champion will be crowned when we get back.